The morning air was crisp and clean as he poked his head through the dog door and sniffed. Freshly sprinkled grass, some fishy-smelling fertilizer under one of the fruit trees, an old dirty sock, probably one he'd grabbed out of the laundry basket to chew on yesterday, a dead rat somewhere up on the hillside, some rotten fruit, squirrel breath. As an audiobook narrator for dogs, I find that it's a really rewarding experience. You know, dogs, they're underutilized and underserviced in the audio world.
They sure are. Say that again.
They don't have a lot of things to listen to. They don't have their own literature or access to their own literature.
Yeah, we don't have access to literature.
But there are more and more dog writers who are beginning to address this underserviced community. And people are writing some pretty incredible stuff. This one's dramatic. Oh yeah? The dog barks at me from a quarter mile away. I can barely hear him, but I can tell he's mad. Not mad like a mad dog, but angry. Got a bug in his ear. Probably, literally. Yeah, I say back to him. Geez, I really have to bark loudly to be heard from inside the house. And another thing, I start to say. But then the humans are in my face, wagging fingers and saying something to me about being quiet. I realize that it's dark, probably a few hours before sunrise. They just don't get it. This dog I'm arguing with is to blame. He's the stupid loudmouth, not me. Why don't you shut up, stupid? I bark. I'm not talking to you anymore. I don't want to get in trouble. Too late. I am in trouble. Dogs appreciate poetry, too. Like this haiku. One of my favorites. Taking a nice nap, I jerk awake, scandalized. The Amazon man. Pick up an audiobook for your dog, why don't you? They'll appreciate it.
Yeah. Would it kill you?